You have the right to call witnesses and cross-examine them if you wish. The name of the justice is Mr. Goodwin. That is how you will address him. Any questions?
Everyone seems to have made up their minds about me. Big, bad Barbara.
Oh, don't flatter yourself.
Well, I've got news for you. The staff here aren't so lily white.
What do you mean?
There's a certain officer who was only too willing to help me get stuff into this place.
Who?
If you don't mind, I think I'll keep it for Mr. Goodwin.
I don't like the look of this.
I think we share the same opinion on the subject of drugs, Mr. Goodwin. Davidson, this is Mr. Goodwin, the visiting justice. You may sit down.
I've been looking at your file here, girlie. I don't like what I see. You've been sentenced here for a filthy crime, and you go on with it in here. I'm wondering whether a little more time in solitary mightn't help you sort yourself out. Well?
I don't know.
What do you have to say for yourself? Well, perhaps we could begin with how you managed to get your wares into the prison. That can't have been easy, even for you.
I had them all along, since I came in.
I didn't come down in the last shower, girlie.
Mr. Goodwin, Davidson told me a completely different story.
Yes?
She said she could implicate a member of staff in this. I assume she meant that someone had turned a blind eye when a parcel arrived.
I never said any such thing.
What? Oh, yes, you did.
Oh, you must have misunderstood me or something. I don't know. Well, I guess I was all mixed up. That solitary really gets to you, and all I meant was I'm terrifically sorry.
Wait outside for a moment, Davidson. What's going on here? I don't think we can just disregard this.
Of course not, but if the girl now denies her story...
She must have a supplier. Could one of the officers or one of the members of the professional staff have been involved?
Oh, I very much doubt it. Well, I have complete confidence in my staff, Mr. Goodwin.
Oh, naturally, naturally.
In any case, she seems to me to have got the message. She may as well go back to her cell for the time being. If there's any truth to her story, we're certainly not going to get at it while she's locked away by herself.
She should be watched.
She will be. We'll have her back now, thank you.
All right.
Well, how are you today, Lynn?
I'm all right.
Anything wrong?
No. Nothing important.
Well, all right. I want to run through a few questions with you that I'll be putting at the trial.
Yeah, I'm listening.
You don't seem very interested.
I said I'm listening. Now you tell me what to say and I'll say it. I'm a good little parrot. Ask anyone.
That isn't quite the idea.
Oh, really? Anyway, with me you should have a pretty good story to tell. Should have them all in tears.
I'm finding this hardened criminal routine rather a bore, then.
Are you? Should talk to my father.
Your father? Is he in town?
He finally showed up.
Well, that's good.
Why?
Apart from anything else, he would make a rather good character witness, don't you think?
You'd have to talk about that with him.
Well, you'd only have to speak about your family background, your home.
Yeah. Well, he's good at that.
Just leave me alone. You got the wrong idea, that's all.
Oh, no, I didn't. I don't know what you think you gain by making enemies for yourself.
I don't. Look, I won't cause any more trouble. I'll be a good, faceless little prisoner from now on in. You don't like me much, do you?
I think you're stupid.
How much money do you think lawyers make?
You ever seen a poor one?
Yeah, they don't have to worry.
It's all the same to them. So, they let you out.
Obviously.
Obviously, you get that? Of course it'd be obviously, with old Davidson for your auntie. See, Wonk? It's not what you know, but who you know in this world.
My aunt had nothing to do with it.
Oh, yeah? Well, other people have tried your racket around here, and the screws came down on them like a ton of bricks.
I can't help that. The VJ let me out. And in any case, Bitch Bennett was playing the show today.
That's because Mrs. Davison took Lizzie off somewhere.
Oh, you'd know. You'd be right in with the screws. Sweet Linny. Butter wouldn't melt in your mouth much.
I see. You call him Wonk here a dog. Well, if anyone's a dog around here, it's you.
You don't scare me.
Oh, well, you're a lot dumber than I thought. You haven't got a friend in this place, dog, except your sweet old auntie.
Give it a break. My aunt put me in solitary, didn't she?
Ah, poor snookums.
Away from me. Anyway, it won't always be this way.
Oh, yeah? Why not? I won't.
Thank you, Miss Bennett. Do we have anyone else to see?
No, there were only three.
If I may say, we got through that very efficiently. I don't mean to criticize, of course, but Mrs. Davidson does tend to let them ramble on and on.
Mrs. Davidson believes in a fair go for the girls.
Oh, yes, as I said. No need to coddle the girls,
oh,
eh?
Certainly not.
Now, take that first girl there. What was her name? Davidson. My first impulse was to be a lot harsher with her. I know that type.
I know what you mean. But then I think we acted as Mrs. Davidson would have wanted.
I don't follow.
Well, you tend to go very carefully when you're dealing with the governor's niece.
I see. Do you mean you had special instructions regarding that girl?
Oh, no, no, don't misunderstand me, Mr. Goodwin. Mrs. Davidson has played it right by the book from the moment her niece was brought in here. Same treatment as any other girl.
Hmm. They had much contact?
Oh, I don't think so. One or two interviews, just as you would expect in the circumstances. It must be terribly embarrassing for her.
Yes. It would be.
Another biscuit, Mr. Goodwin?
Well, this is the address the doctor gave me.
Well, you better lock your car up. You never know who's about.
No.
Oh, God. The last time I seen me brother, he had his backside out of his tweeds. Oh, sorry, Mrs. Davidson.
Yes, well, shall we go in? Lizzie?
Oh.
The bell's off, Al. Go ting-a-ling-a-ling. Yes?
Good afternoon. I'm Mrs. Davidson, and this is Mrs. Birdsworth.
Yes. All right. Disgusting, isn't it? The whole place is like this. The doctor's here. I'll fetch him.
He always was a bit of a magpie.
This table's genuine Chippendale.
Yeah? That's in Sydney, isn't it?
I think we'd better be careful with that.
It's only old junk, isn't it?
Well, I'm no expert, but I'd say that little piece is worth about $100. It's Limoges china.
Oh, Limoges china. Yeah, it is quite pretty.
Ah, ladies, sorry to keep you. I'm Dr. Kroll. So good of you, Mrs. Davidson, to open your heart to a dying man's appeal.
Hey, I'm his sister. Let's get on with it. Where is he?
He's asleep. But before you go in, perhaps you can help us. So far, he's flatly refused to go to hospital. But frankly, his condition is such I really must insist. Now, if you could persuade him to accept it without any argument, it would be better for him.
Of course, Doctor. That's the least I can do. Perhaps I could sit beside his bed and hold his dear old hand while he's asleep. We've been apart so long. Every moment's precious.
But this way, then.
Oh.
The only way Doctor can get him off is to let him have the brandy.
Really? I'll just park myself here and be as quiet as a mouse.
Very well, Mrs. Birdsworth. Perhaps Sister could make some tea.
Well, if you like.
The last time I seen you, you borrowed 50 quid, you old fox. But I'm not even going to mention that. What's 50 quid? Ha ha!